Gracious Word, presented by Church of Christ.
Dear friends, we greet you all in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and we welcome you all to this Gracious Word English television program. This is a new beginning, and we encourage you to study the Bible with us through this program every week, the same day, the same time. Really, we want to encourage you to search the scriptures, as the Holy Bible says. John chapter 5 verse 39 says like this: "You search the scriptures, for in them you think you have eternal life, and these are they which testify of me." Really, there is a blessing in searching the scriptures, studying the word of God. And we are sure that you will be blessed by studying the word of God with us through this program. When we read the New Testament, in Acts chapter 17 verse 11, we can see a group of holy people, the church in Berea. They were fair-minded than the Thessalonians, the Bible says, because they searched the scriptures daily. And through this program, we would like to encourage you to be blessed by the Almighty God by searching the scriptures and studying the word of God. There is an abundance of blessings when we search the scriptures. Now, coming to our program, God willing, we will be studying in a systematic way, starting from Genesis. We will cover book by book and study the scriptures and search the scriptures. Of course, we will not be studying every verse of every chapter and every book, but we will be covering the most important things mentioned in the scriptures, starting from Genesis. Today, I would like to quote you the verse for our meditation, today's meditation. It will be from Genesis chapter 4 verse 7. "If you do well, will you not be accepted? And if you do not do well, sin lies at the door, and its desire is for you, but you should rule over it." My beloved people, through this verse, we can learn what God says about sin and its effects. Of course, sin affects everyone. In Romans chapter 3 verse 23, you can read that all have sinned and they have fallen short of the glory of God. Yes, everyone in this world, whoever were born and whoever were going to be born, they all have sinned and they have fallen short of the God's glory. So today we are going to discuss or meditate from this Genesis chapter 4 verse 7, that what are the effects of sin. Especially, we can find a word in that verse, you can note that one: sin lies at the door. This is what we are going to meditate today. Sin lies at the door. When we are breaking the law of God, when we are not obeying the law of God, we are automatically committing sin. And the word of God tells us that sin will lie at our door. It has its own effect. It condemns our life. We have to face the consequences of what we have done. That is what we have sinned. So this is what we are going to meditate today. So this is the phrase that we are going to meditate from Genesis chapter 4 verse 7. Sin lies at the door. So let us see what is the nature of sin. Sin affects everyone. It affects everyone. That is what we have seen from Romans chapter 3 verse 23. And also it has a deadly effect. There is no mild effect. There are no scratches. It will not be like small wound. When sin enters us, or when we commit sin, it has a deadly effect. We have to remember that one, please. So the other thing is, sin is present everywhere. We cannot escape from it unless we have decided to follow the God's word. when we are falling back from God's word, when we are automatically decided not to obey God's word, we will be committing sin and we have to face the consequences. Beloved, I like to discuss with you some points about the nature of sin based on this verse, Genesis chapter 4 verse 7. We have to first note down that the first point I like to discuss is sin, it comes to us as if it is going to be our servant. And when we accept it and keep sinning, it makes us its slave, or we become its servant. This is what happened in the Garden of Eden. When Satan, in the form of serpent, it came to Eve, it had polite words. But when it made Eve to sin, we can clearly see that Eve became slave for sin. Adam and Eve became slave for sin, and ultimately at the end God chased them out of the garden. So this is what happens. Jesus tells us this in John chapter 8 verse 34. Jesus answered them, "Most assuredly I say to you, whoever commits sin is a slave of sin." So we cannot overrule sin. If we are committing sin, if you are beginning to taste sin, it makes us its slave. And also we can read from 2 Peter chapter 2 verse 19. The Bible tells like this: "While they promise them liberty, they themselves are slaves of corruption. For by whom a person is overcome, by him also he is brought into bondage." So these verses clearly tells us that when we are sinning, we automatically become slaves for sin or slaves for Satan, and we go away from God. So kindly be cautious about sin, because its nature is, it comes politely with kind-heartedness. It shows itself like it's kind-hearted, and when it enters us, it makes us its slave. The second thing I would like to share with you regarding the nature of sin is that sin appears to be beautiful, but its nature is ugly. Again, take the example of the Satan, serpent meeting Eve in the Garden of Eden. We can see that Eve found the forbidden fruit. It was nice to to see. It was beautiful. So that is the nature of sin. God forbidden that fruit, but Satan tells Eve that if you eat that fruit, your eyes will be open and you will become like God. And for Eve, the fruit appeared to be very beautiful, very tasty to eat. So this is the nature of sin. It appears to be beautiful, but its real nature is ugly. Genesis chapter 3 verse 6, we can read the encounter of Eve with Satan. That we can see this nature is clearly explained there. Again, in the example of David and Bathsheba, if you read 2 Samuel chapter 11 verse 2, "Then it happened one evening that David arose from his bed and walked on the roof of the king's house. And from the roof he saw a woman bathing, and the woman was very beautiful to behold." It's not just to David the king to take another man's wife. But you see, for him, for David, women appeared very beautiful. This is the real nature of sin. The third one, the third nature of sin that we will be discussing today is, it seems to be right. Sin seems to be right, but it is wrong. Beloved, this statement is exactly true with reference to today's happening in the world. You see, you can see many sins are being legalized. You can see the relationships before marriage, homosexuality, living together like that, and social drinking. These are very ugly sins condemned by the Bible. But nowadays you can see even governments, they are accepting this. Even they pass laws to accept this kind of ugly sins. So this is what the nature of sin is. It appears to be right, but its nature is really wrong. 1 John chapter 3 verse 4 says like this: "Whoever commits sin also commits lawlessness, and sin is a lawlessness. And again, 1 John chapter 5 verse 17 says, all unrighteousness is sin, and there is sin not leading to death. So we have to remember what the Bible says about sin. All unrighteousness is sin, and whoever commits sin commits lawlessness. So when the Bible condemns something, the Bible has a law towards sin. So when we overgo that one, when we do away from that one, so we are committing sin. And again, I like to quote with you Isaiah chapter 5 verse 20. Woe to those who call evil good and good evil, who put darkness for light and light for darkness, who put bitter for sweet and sweet for bitter. This is what happens today. People call darkness as light, and people tell that bitter as sweet. So this is the nature of sin. It appears to be right, but according to the word of God, according to the Almighty God, it's really wrong. Whichever is condemned by the word of God is sin, and we have to keep away from it. The final thing I'd like to discuss with you about the nature of sin is, by saying you will not reap what you sow. The sin says like this, okay, you do nothing will happen, there will be no effect, everything is okay, like this it will tell. Sin will be telling to us like this. But the word of God says, we have to reap what we sow. Even the world says, according to Newton's third law, every action has an equal and opposite reaction. The word of God says, Judges chapter 1 verse 7, 70 kings with their thumbs and big toes cut off used to gather scraps under my table. As I have done, so God has repaid me. Then they brought him to Jerusalem, and there he died. As I have done, so God has repaid me. This is what God's nature in with reference to sin. When we sin, we commit lawlessness. We are doing something against God, and God will surely repay. It will be on our head. He is going to repay that. If you are doing evil thing, we will reap evil thing in our life or in the life of our children. We have to remember that one. Dear friends, before we conclude, we like to remind you and review what we have seen today regarding the nature of sin. So sin is a terrible thing. God doesn't like that. So when we commit sin, we go away from God, and we have to face the consequences. So kindly let us dedicate ourselves to God's word and keep away from sin. Finally, I'd like to quote a verse from Ecclesiastes chapter 12 verse 13. Fear God and keep his commandments. Fear God and keep his commandments. This is what God expects from every human being. I commend you to the word of God, and be blessed by God. And thank you for watching this program. Stay tuned to watch this Bible study program every week at this same time, same day. May God bless you as you dedicate yourself to study the word of God. Thank you once again.
Be blessed by studying the word of God. To receive the Voice of Truth International magazine and to study the Bible systematically through our English Bible correspondent course, kindly write to us. Our address: Gracious Word, P.O. Box 15, Arasradi, Madurai, 625016, Tamil Nadu. For more details, dial 9244204420, 9244214421. God bless you.
The Church of Christ salutes you.